So here we are in the beautiful Fairfield. This is the home of the wonderful Philippe, who's right here beside me. And
you have a little car.
Little orange beetle. That's it. Yeah.
You got that a long time, haven't you?
Ah, yeah, like 25, 30 years now. Yeah.
Right, yeah.
I will say, what I was amazed when I spoke to you, and I suppose it is natural that you've lived here for 8 years.
Yeah.
And when this notice came on August 8th, you were actually okay with it. You sort of feel, you said yourself, it's not like it's a beautiful home that you're nice and warm in the winter. So
I miss it, but I need a new place because this place is not insulated.
Right.
It's not insulated at all. It's just hollow walls.
Ah, okay. Well, I know that in the Irish Times story this morning, I talked to two different people, Joel Clark and Conal and his girlfriend, that there was a sense that, you know, these houses weren't great to live in, that they were suffering from rising damp and stuff like that. Yeah.
The walls are not insulated. They're just like cardboard boxes. They are cardboard.
Ah. Now, when it came to this announcement on August 8th, and it sort of made national news, I know RTE are here today as well, and there's a few others. I mean, I don't know if all of you guys got together when the letters arrived, whether it was just...
No, they don't. People don't get together here at all.
Right, okay.
No, they don't.
And was that something, though, that was discussed, you know, as time went by? Surely you meet each other and, you know, this is a big deal because is it about a year away that the eviction notice is for?
August next year, yeah.
August next year, right, yeah. Okay. But it must have been like a conversation. Was there any kind of hint that...
None at all.
Wow,
no,
right.
Everyone keeps themselves here.
Okay.
Really, yeah.
And I read that there was 52 mobile homes and chalets here and up to about 100 people live here. It's going to affect... You know, a lot of lives, really, because, you know, for some it's the choices are very, very difficult around grey zones. If you have 55,000 sitting down the back of the sofa, you can buy a house in Marina Village. But other than that, chances are it'll be very difficult to live here because rent, I think the cheapest rent somebody found was 1,130 a week in some on daft.ie.
See, if I don't get a council house, we're not going to be able to afford to get it in another place.
Right. But that's got to be, obviously the council, thankfully, have said that they're looking into it, and I'm sure that's always going to be the case, that they'll say that they're looking into it and they're doing what they can. But in a way, that there is a time limit on this, that you really have to get somewhere now by next August.
Yeah.
Do you get that sense that people are generally okay with it here? Do you get the sense that there is a kind of a deep concern? Like, there must be a sadness. It's been here since 1973. You've been here 8 years. I'm sure there's many who have been here for even longer than that. So
I've been here 20 years.
Yeah. So that's home, you know, that is for some. Yeah. And it is, you know, there's beauty around here. It's a lovely spot. You're kind of
it's
nicely
very
in
quiet,
a
quiet, it's very private.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
It is that.
So that there must be I'm sure that if it's accepted that this is going to happen, that it is going to close, there must be a certain amount of sadness to
there is a little bit, yeah, because of the privacy of it all.
Right.
And he looks after the grounds. He's in here every day of the week.
Right.
With another guy, you know Simon Kelly?
Yeah, I know him to see now. I know him, they say hello to, yeah. So they look after the place well.
What a nosy person he is.
Yeah. But it's good that they, it does seem beautifully maintained and as I said, it's got a long history, so it does seem to be part of the town. Would you have a feeling about why it's moving on? I know that in the letter that the landlord sort of stated that it was because of, you know, increasing, you know, new legislation and so forth on landlords.
I didn't hear that at all. No.
Well, this is apparently one of the statements. He wasn't available for comment, but he did sort of issue a statement that it was down to the fact that, you know, as a landlord, it was becoming more and more difficult for him to comply with the new legislation. But
what are the new regulations?
Well, I'm guessing that it would also have to do possibly with the fact that this is prime location for you know, as regards properties, if you are going to build, this would be one of the nicest spots you could probably build on around here because you're right by the harbour.
That's what I think is going to happen.
Yeah. I doubt it's going to be...
It'll go private.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to return to being a meadow or anything like that. I would imagine it'll go private.
No.
Right. And you yourself now, have you been in touch with the council since you got the notice about your situation?
I didn't get any notice. Like,
okay, all right. I thought there was a letter sent out. Maybe it wasn't sent to every single resident. I would have thought, I'd hoped that they would have. But apparently August 8th, there was a letter sent out that generally said, this is the circumstances that we have to basically give you notice of eviction because, you know, our circumstances have changed.
He didn't much to say. This is It's good. The good thing about it was he gave us a year to get out of here.
Right.
It's not like
you have a
month to get out or anything like that.
Yeah.
So it's this time next year. We're
okay. And you have a good relationship then with the landlord. He comes around as well. You're saying with
he's here working every day.
Well, that's great then that he's involved.
And Simon Kelly with
right.
Him.
So your relationship would be good with him, like you'd have
a sort of.
And have you spoken to him about it directly? Because you know, if you see him regularly, I don't know whether it's come up in conversation that you know he sort of said, well, you know, like, this is why, and this is the. This is, you know, the reasons behind.
No, I never detailed anything.
Okay. All right. Well, I know that you're one resident now that, as you said, you're happy to move on, really, because you've been here 8 years, but you're maybe sick of cold and wet winters now at this stage. And, you know, you need your bit of insulation.
No,
you
need my own. Yeah. I need a place I can call my own.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
If
well,
we've got a council house now. It would be.
Yeah. Well, we'll certainly follow it up, and I think now because it's become a national news story, I think there will be movement on this.
Hello,
it'll be a lot more likely to local celebrity Jackie Johnson and RTE. Holy moly, you see that? You're now going to be famous down here. So yeah, we'll certainly follow up, and we'll try and find out from the various councillors in the town what their plan is, how they feel about what will be done. Because
Jackie said she's keeping text me and let me
know
what's happening.
Great. Okay. Well, certainly we'll get on the case too, because. And there's certainly some good councillors around here, and they'd be concerned that people are okay and that they have somewhere to go. And it'll be interesting to see now. It'll probably take maybe two years' time, just see what's here then, you know. I don't think, as I said, it'll return to a meadow. I think we'll end up with fancy houses here.
I think it'll go private houses. Yeah. That's what I think anyway.
Okay. Well, I wish you the best of luck, Philip, and certainly I'll keep you informed too. I'll call by and let you know if I hear anything. And Yeah. Hopefully not at all.
Stephen Donnelly, he's not around much now, is he?
Well, he's. I know that he's quite a busy man now. You know, he's in the Dáil, so that sort of direct kind of actual physical presence is probably more difficult for him because he's. But I'll get on the case. I'll get my big stick out and I'll make sure that he people get response.
Or shotgun.
There you go.